Hello and welcome to the Faith Cafe, wherever you are. We are the body of Christ. Even though we're all in different homes, different places, just know as you worship with us that there are people all over the world, believers, worshipping together at this moment, that you are not alone and that you are embraced as part of the body of Christ.
Forsaken, I've been set free. can see the love in your eyes, laying yourself down. You're raising up the broken to
Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the desert, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil.
want, Jesus? How about some fire?
He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them he was hungry. The devil said to him,
If you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread.
It is written, Man will not live on bread alone.
The devil led him up to a high place and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And he said to him,
I will give you all their authority and splendor, for it has been given to me.
And I can give it to anyone I want to, so if you worship me, it will all be yours.
It is written, Worship the Lord your God, and serve him only.
Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple.
If you are the Son of God, then throw yourself down from here. It is written that he will command the angels concerning you to guard you carefully. They will lift up their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone.
It says, Do not put the Lord your God to the test.
Then the devil left him, and angels came and attended him.
To you, O Lord, we lift up our hearts, offering worship and praise. Show us your path, teach us to follow, guide us in your truth. For our hope is in you all day long.
Loving, faithful God, your love is absolute, your promises are forever. We look up after a shower of rain, marvelling at the colourful beauty. Whenever we happen to be in a difficult place, whether in the valley, in the wilderness, mountain or road, your Holy Spirit is with us. We adore you, loving, faithful God.
A prayer of confession. Beloved Lord Jesus, you step from water to wilderness. From God's voice to the taunting voice of the enemy. In the wilderness of today's world, we face many enemies, many temptations. Forgive us for succumbing to selfishness, greed, lust, anger, power. Lord Most High, forgive us, we pray. Help us not to wallow in selfish, self-centeredness, but to remember your promise and recognize you and those you bring alongside. Lord Most High, forgive us, we pray.
Lord, will you forgive us when our minds fail to focus on you and your word? Help us to remember that no matter what we're going through, you've been there before us. Whether we're basking in the warm waters of your love, or journeying through a dry and cold wilderness of suffering and pain. Help us not to lose sight of your hand that lovingly guides us to eternal glory at the end of that rainbow. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you went from water to wilderness, to suffering on the cross. There you, beloved Son of God, died in your physical body for our sins. Through your blood, we're washed clean of all our guilt, and we're able to enter the presence of God with whom you now sit, having been raised in the Spirit. All angels, powers and authorities submit to you. Because of you, we are forgiven. Praise be to Jesus, our Lord and Saviour. Amen.
We thank you, faithful Lord, for your patience, your provision, and your power, for your tenderness and your trust in us, for your security and strength, for your compassion and wisdom. We thank you, Lord, that through your grace and mercy, the blessings of faith and of covenant love, you equip us, you teach us, you guide us, you train us to traverse this world, ever mindful of your steadfast love. Amen.
Today's reading is from Luke chapter 4 verses 1 to 13 and is from the NIV UK translation. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing during those days, and at the end of them he was hungry. The devil said to him, If you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread. Jesus answered, It is written, Man shall not live on bread alone. The devil led him up to a high place and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And he said to him, I will give you all their authority and splendor. It has been given to me, and I can give it to anyone I want to. If you worship me, it will be yours. Jesus answered, It is written, Worship the Lord your God and serve him only. The devil led him to Jerusalem and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. If you are the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, He will command his angels concerning you to guard you carefully. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. Jesus answered, It is said, Do not put the Lord your God to the test. When the devil had finished all this tempting, he left him until an opportune time.
It would be wonderful, wouldn't it, to imagine that as God's covenant children, we were all dancing and rejoicing under the promises of that wonderful rainbow that reminds us that God does not break his faithfulness to us forever. For those who are on their own and feeling vulnerable and isolated, I think this time is just so hard. And I thought if we could just look at Jesus in his time in the desert, then we might be able to just gain some insight about these wilderness experiences which are so hard for us as human beings. Because let's face it, God has made us for community, didn't he say to Noah and his families and to all the animals, go forth and multiply and be fruitful and fill the earth. And so many of us are not feeling at all fruitful at the moment. This lack of community, this being cooped up, it's not good for us. It's not good for our mental health. Now, in the wilderness, he was hungry and he was therefore vulnerable to temptation. He knows who he is. He knows that he is God's son. If we can remind ourselves that we are God's child, that God loves us and delights in us. You are my child and I am delighted in you, as God said to Jesus when he came out of the waters at his baptism, remember. If we can remember that, if we can hold on to that, then perhaps we won't fall into some of the pitfalls that are so common. Hungry and weak, Jesus is mercilessly tested in the wilderness by Satan, who is personified as an actual being. Now, perhaps it would be easier for us when we're undergoing temptation to see the tempter as this sort of dark hooded figure or as some films portray evil, a beautiful woman or a proud leader. We often don't recognise when we are being tempted, or if we do, we see it as something which is within ourselves. I think the great thing that we can learn is that Jesus doesn't feed those temptations. He actually shrugs them off. Straight away, he comes up with a godly reason why he should not go along that path. And that's it. Over. You see, it isn't a sin to be tempted. Even Jesus was tempted. And so he doesn't give in, but he holds on to what he knows is true in his heart, his mind, and his conscience. Just as Jesus was tempted, we will be as well. And it won't be fair. It will be when we're at our most vulnerable, when we're at our most in need, perhaps depressed, anxious, sick, or in grief, let down or hurt by somebody. Those are the times when temptations come. Now, Jesus's temptations seem to be about his identity as God's son. If you are the Son of God, prove it by being sensational. If you are the Son of God, use your miraculous gifts to turn these stones into bread. If you are the Son of God, look, here's all the kingdoms of the world and you can have all this. Now, Jesus, being secure in his identity as God's beloved Son, didn't need to prove himself. He may have been tempted, but he immediately shrugs those temptations off and says out loud, so that he can hear and that the tempter can hear as well, what is the truth, what he knows in his conscience to be right. So immediately he says, no, I'm not going to turn these stones into bread because I don't need to. God says, man shall not live by bread alone. God's word sustains me. This is what he is saying to himself. I'm sustained by God's word. So it wasn't about breaking his fast, but it was about misusing those gifts that God had given him. And he just knew in his conscience that it wasn't the right thing to do. When we give in to one temptation, then they come thick and fast, and it is just so much more difficult. Once you start to give in, it's just better not to go there, isn't it? And he doesn't go there. And when it's all over, the angels come and minister to him. By that, I would presume that they bring him food and nourishment because his fast has finished and he's at a very weak point, so that he knows that his Father is going to provide everything he needs. But there is still that temptation to go and do it yourself, which he doesn't entertain. Now, the other temptations are more about the way that we use our sphere of influence, of power, or control, if you like. And I think if you look in any organisation, including religious organisations, you'll see that there are so many examples of where people fall into this temptation and it causes so much hurt for others, the misuse of power and control. And of course, any power or influence that we are entrusted with has to be for the benefit of humanity, to bless others. But when we desire fame or glory or the acquisition of wealth, it doesn't end well. It's not good. We may gain the whole world, but we will lose our own souls, our sense of self. In the New Testament, there's a passage that tells us about putting on the whole armour of God. Things like truth and faith as a shield, and shoes of peace, which I always imagine as those kind of shoes we used to wear for athletics, that sort of had spikes on them and you couldn't fall over in the mud. But to wear the armour of God that will keep us safe. And the same passage tells us that when we've put on that armour, when we've done all that we can, we must stand. And it is a standing together as well, putting on the armour of God with other soldiers of Christ, other believers. I think in these times, these wilderness times, these desert times when life is so painful, sometimes all we can do is stand. It is enough simply to stand, to stand in God, to stand in your faith. You may not feel strong, it matters not. The Apostle Paul says, when I am weak, I am strong. When you are weak, you are strong. When you ask God to help you, to make you strong. And so let's stand in the strength of Jesus Christ, and let's emulate Jesus in the wilderness as he shrugged these temptations away. We're going to feed those good things in our life, our relationship with God, our relationship with others, hard as that may be at the moment. Seek to ensure that as we meet our genuine needs, we do it in such a way that is not hurtful to either ourselves or others. Let's have a prayer. Loving God, thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for the rainbow of your covenant under which we stand, your covenant faithfulness. And we know that you are with us always, not always in the green pastures and the places of sweet streams, but also on the rugged mountain or the lonely wildness of the desert. Lord, many of us feel so isolated at the moment, so alone or worried or sick or exhausted or hurt. Lord, will you heal us? Will you heal us all, everyone who is listening to this today? Will you strengthen us? Will you fill us with your Spirit? Help us to shrug away these temptations, to not to feed them, not to invest them with too much significance or to dwell on them, but rather to give our attention to things that are good and beautiful. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your faithfulness to me.
hope you've enjoyed our time of worshipping God and praying together and knowing that many other believers all over the world are worshipping God at the same time. If you haven't already subscribed to the Faith Cafe, then do just click on the red subscribe button if you would like to. And let's finish with a blessing. May the blessing of faithfulness and steadfast love from our covenant God be with you all evermore, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Нас записав.